Number seven, Gillingham away. We won promotion that day. Obviously, we played some great football through the season in League One under Roberto Martinez. It was a long journey, but Bussy got two goals there, and obviously we got promotion that day. So it was a great bus journey back to Swansea and out in our tracksuits, and you know, one of my favourite memories. Number six, I'll choose Cardiff in the League Cup in 2008. I think it was the first time the derby had happened for maybe 10 years or so, and obviously it was my first ever derby game. It was a night game. I just remember during the day driving through town and just feeling the buzz around the place, and then getting to the ground, the atmosphere in the warm-up, you could tell it was a special game, and obviously the atmosphere during the match was brilliant. We won the game 1-0, Jordi Gomez scoring a bit of a deflected free kick. But no, it was my first ever taste of a derby game. I got man of the match, and like I say, the atmosphere that night was electric. Number five, Bradford in the League Cup final. Obviously our first major trophy as a football club, my first major honour as a professional footballer as well. Great day at Wembley. It was a bit of an anti-climax, if I'm being honest, the final. 5-0, it was over really before half-time, and then obviously the keeper got sent off. But no, it was a great day, obviously, winning at Wembley of all, you know, 40,000 Swansea fans there, obviously a lot of family there, being close to London, so the first major honour in my career is one that obviously will stick in the memory. Number four would be Nottingham Forest in the playoff semi-final at the Liberty Stadium. Obviously we drew away at Nottingham 0-0, going down to 10 men after 60 seconds, tails getting sent off, and a great result, but obviously coming back to the Liberty Stadium, the atmosphere again that night was, I think, one of the best I've ever witnessed at the Liberty Stadium. We took the lead, obviously, for myself, a very rare goal, left foot swinger, but went 2-0 up with Stephen Dobin, and Forrest come back 2-1 and was really pushing to get the equaliser. I think Earnshaw hit the post, and then Lee Camp come up for the corner right at the end, and obviously it happened with Darren Prattley scoring from the halfway line, and we all remember the celebrations of Brendan running down the touchline and the pitch invasion at the end, and all the players in the dugout, in the director's box. So, you know, a great night at the Liberty, and definitely one of the best. And number three, I'd say, is my debut for Swansea and in professional football. Probably not the best of grounds I've played at, Exeter away in a cold and rainy December, but it was obviously a dream for me playing professional football and doing it at Swansea. I remember a few bits of the game, making a few tackles and the fans singing my name. Very early on, we lost the game 1-0, I can't remember who scored for Exeter, but I remember playing against Martin Thomas and Kwame Ampadu, two ex-Swansea midfielders, and having to learn very quickly that it can be quite physical in League Two, but it was a dream come true, making my league debut. Number two for me would be the playoff final against Reading at Wembley. Obviously going after the Forest game, going to Wembley, arriving to the stadium. We just remember so many fans there. It was like literally black and white everywhere, tens of thousands of Swansea fans, and then the warm-up with, obviously everyone knows about Kevin John's speech. The actual game, it couldn't have gone any better for us, 3-0 up so quickly, and half-time we try to say in the change room that, you know, the job's not done and there's still another 45 minutes to go, and then we start the second half off and, you know, Reading score two fairly early goals and we're hanging on, and Gary Monk makes that amazing block to keep it at 3-2, because I think we all know if it was 3-0, I think we all know Reading would probably have gone on to win the game. But obviously a penalty from Scotty Sinclair at the end, his hat-trick and promotion to the Premier League, and doing it in front of 40,000 Swansea fans. And I think also what made it special was getting the promotion with a lot of lads that have been together a long time, not just teammates but good friends, and doing it together in front of 40,000 Swansea fans at Wembley was an incredible day. I'd say my number one game for Swansea, the top one that stands out, would be Hull City at home in 2003. The importance of that game was huge for the football club, never been relegated out of the Football League. So we went into that game needing to win, knowing that a win would keep us in it. The game, I remember it being typical Swansea day, if you like, pouring down with rain. Started off well, 1-0 up, and all of a sudden we're 2-1 down, and you felt the atmosphere change completely in the stadium. But thankfully, we went on to win 4-2. James Thomas being the local hero, getting the hat-trick, his fourth one, a wonderful chip from 25, 30 yards. And I think just the relief of everyone around the football club, the city, of winning that game, making sure we stay in the Football League. And we speak about Premier League football now and all the memories we've had. I think if we're being honest, if we lost that game, we wouldn't be where we are today. And I certainly wouldn't be sat here talking about playing 15 years for Swansea. So that game was so important for the football club, and I'm just delighted that we got the win, and it was the catalyst to where we are today.